Good morning, High Crest family. Happy Friday. Kim Kinesny here, excited to be doing Jumpstart with you. We are going to be in the book of Titus, chapter 3, verses 1 through 7, and I'll be reading from the NLT version. So we'll go ahead and get started. Remind the believers to submit to the government and its officers. They should be obedient, always ready to do what is good. They must not slander anyone and must avoid quarreling. Instead, they should be gentle and show true humility to everyone. Once we too were foolish and disobedient. We were misled and became slaves to many lusts and pleasures. Our lives were full of evil and envy, and we hated each other. But when God our Savior revealed his kindness and love, he saved us. Not because of the righteous things we had done, but because of his mercy. He washed away our sins, giving us a new birth and new life through the Holy Spirit. He generously poured out the Spirit upon us through Jesus Christ our Savior. Because of his grace, he made us right in his sight and gave us confidence that we will inherit eternal life. So for me, this passage is kind of divided into two parts. And during the first part, Paul is really telling Titus to remind the people he is leading how to live as Christian citizens. They should respect and obey the government as long as they weren't going against God's laws. They should be kind to one another. They should avoid quarreling. And even if people were insulting them, they should not be insulting them back. So they could have their own opinion, but they shouldn't be engaging in quarrels or fights with people that they disagreed with. And then the second part of the passage really tells us why Christians should be living differently. It's because we are living in freedom because Jesus Christ came and died for our sins, not because they deserved it, but because God is good and he is generous. And because of that, Christians are promised eternal life. And so they should be living differently. And it really got me thinking about what this means in the context of today. And especially since we're in the middle of a really divisive election season that's already gotten pretty nasty. And the passage starts by telling us that we're supposed to submit to government. It does not tell us to submit to only Christian government or to submit to a certain party or how to vote or even if we should vote. But what the Bible is really clear about is how we should engage with people that have a different opinion than ours. Paul says to be gracious and kind, to not quarrel or insult people, especially or even if they insult us. So what if, as Christians, we decided this election season that we're going to be different, that we're going to live differently, we're going to live in the freedom that we have in Christ, and that we are going to rest in the peace of knowing that no matter who wins this election, no matter who is president or governor or congressman or senator, it really ultimately doesn't matter because Jesus Christ is still king. And he is ultimately the one sitting on the throne. He is in control and he wins. Ultimately he wins, right? So my challenge to you this election season is just to live differently. Avoid political fights. Live as someone who has all the confidence in the world and knowing ultimately we know who's in control. We know Christ is returning. We know we're going to have eternal life with him. So I love you all. I hope you have a great weekend. Continue to power up, pour in, and spill out, and we will see you on Monday.